bouncing ball. And the ball game is over. And Greg Maddux has won his 15th game of the year. He lost 11. That's a fourth straight year that he has won 15 or more. And the Cubs have salvaged the final game of the year and have swept the three-game series with the St. Louis Cardinals. Well, a lot of things happened today, and they were all great, and they were all thrilling, and they were all dramatic. Too bad we couldn't have had a victory that meant a pennant, but that will come. Sure as God made green apples, someday the Chicago Cubs are going to be in a World Series, and maybe sooner than we think. It seems to me that we don't have too much time. It seems the ingredients, the nucleus is there. It's just a matter, I don't know who the manager's going to be. I don't know whether it be Essien, whether it be Jim Fry, whether it be Davey Johnson. One thing's certain, it requires a veteran manager because this is a veteran team. It's a mixture of guys who are young, but still are veterans. All right. The final score, the Cubs win the ball game by the score of 7-3. Maddux now 11-7. Oliveras, 15-11 for Maddux. Oliveras now 11-7. Total 7-10-2 for the Cubs. 3-6-0 for the Mets. Speaking for Steve Stone and Tom Brenneman, I'm sure we thanked everybody that we possibly have the time to thank. This is Harry Caray from Wrigley Field. Until next spring, God willing, so long, everybody. All right! For the last time this year, so let me hear you, good and loud, a one, a two, a three, take me out to the ball game. Take me out to the... Well, the Cubs' 1992 season opener will be between the Cubs and the Philadelphia Phillies, Tuesday, April the 7th, in Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, only 184 days away. So long, everybody.